Constantino. Actually, my name should be familiar to you because I have called your staff quite often, and if they're doing their job, they should have told you that I was familiar with Jake and James in Washington. I've got so many questions, it's hard to pin down. Right now, I'm so sick of what's going on in Syria, with what's happening with the Kurds. I know you came out against that, but what on earth is Congress? I know they're thinking about sanctioning Turkey. What good is that going to be? These people are dying today. And Trump says they didn't work with us in World War II. But you know they didn't fight with us in any of our wars, including Korea. But neither did he. This is killing me. I was so astounded at his betrayal and abandonment of these people who have been allies to us. And he doesn't think that that's going to hurt us in the future. What are you going to do about it now, today? Not do sanctions.
Sure, so it's a very important thing. I think one of the most important tools you have as a policymaker is using your voice. And I have spoken out when I disagreed with President Trump. This is one where I vehemently disagreed. Was one of the first voices to say, this is unacceptable, not just because of this particular incident, where very tragically lives will be lost, but what this means in the future when our partners and allies don't think that they can rely on us. I just came back I went on a congressional delegation, it's bipartisan. We went to Afghanistan, Turkey, and Jordan, and we got briefed on the Syria situation. And my real concern in the short term is, obviously we fought side by side the SDF and the Kurds, and to leave them to, frankly, just be in horrific circumstances where their lives are very much at risk is unacceptable. But what also is a concern to me is, as we think about countering groups like ISIS, which the SDF and the Kurds were focused on, we're gonna leave a real void. And there is a prison with those hardened ISIS fighters, with over 11,000 hardened ISIS fighters. That prison is not to be manned by the SDF as they are dealing with the Turks invading that part of Syria. So I'm deeply concerned. We are doing the sanctions bill, it's bipartisan, so you have bipartisan condemnation with very senior senators from both sides of the aisle. I will be one of the original Republicans on the Republican side, but this is an area where I disagree with the president. I also think our Syria policy has been, we haven't really had a Syria policy in two administrations. I think that has been a weakness of our national security, as we've let the Assad regime get strengthened, as we've let Russia fill that void. And I've had a clear and consistent record on standing up for the importance of America to stick by our partners. But I'm deeply concerned about it, especially coming back from that recent delegation visit. Because it's gonna have repercussions in Jordan and other countries in the region.
I'm aware of it, and I keep up with it. But what are they doing? Because while we're talking, everybody bipartisan is sanctioning. What are they going to do to save these people's lives? 11,000 men and women. And how many are dying now? Sanctions are fine, eventually.
Yeah, hopefully other countries will speak out as well and really pressure and try to work with this administration. I think military leadership needs to continue to update the president of what's happening on the ground. But this is an area where I have an independent view. And I appreciate your concern, and thanks for following it so closely. I know, particularly given the number of active duty military that are in this district deployed in the Middle East, appreciate constituents who are following what's happening in that volatile region. Thank you.
The next person that had a question is Cindy Fradigan.
Okay.